T-minus 30 seconds.
Stage one, pressing for flight.
T-minus 15 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition, liftoff.
Vehicle is pitching downrange.
Stage one throttle bucket.
Power and telemetry nominal.
For those of you just joining us, you are watching a live view of the Falcon 9 rocket as it ascends through the atmosphere carrying the SpaceX Dragon 2 capsule to
vehicle
orbit.
Vehicle is supersonic.
The vehicle just passed through max Q, which is the point of maximum aerodynamic pressure on the vehicle. As you can hear in the background, the excitement at SpaceX headquarters is unbelievable here.
Stage one throttle.
The vehicle is passing through max Q.
You heard that call out from max Q on the nets. The Falcon 9 actually throttles down its 9 Merlin engines to reduce aerodynamic loads on the vehicle. It is now throttling those engines back up. Coming up at T plus 2 minutes and 35 seconds is going to be three events in quick succession. The first one is going to be the main engine cutoff, or MECO. That's when the 9 Merlin 1D engines that you can see on your screen right now will cut off shortly before a stage separation at 2 minutes and 38 seconds. Shortly after that, the Merlin vacuum engine on the bottom of the second stage of the Falcon 9 will ignite in what we call second engine start, or SES. That'll be at 2 minutes and 46 seconds. So stand by for main engine cutoff, stage separation, and second engine start coming up in just about 20 seconds from now. As you can hear from the cheering here at SpaceX headquarters, we did have a successful main engine cutoff, a stage separation, and as you can see on the right-hand side of your screen, that second stage engine is currently started and accelerating Dragon towards orbit. On the left-hand side of your screen, that is a view from the first stage as it makes its way back down towards the Earth. Let's go down to Lauren and Dan for updates on that first stage recovery.
All right, so as you can just see, we lifted off. We had an awesome liftoff of stage one, and stage two is burning beautifully. Stage one also has a secondary mission that it is performing right now, which is getting ready to come back to the drone ship and land. So stage one is going to execute two burns before landing on the drone ship. The first is the entry burn start, which is starting at T plus 7 minutes and 48 seconds approximately. That's where three of the M1D engines will reignite. And what that burn does is it slows down stage one as it re-enters the upper parts of the Earth's atmosphere. If we didn't do that, that aerodynamic re-entry heating, the aero heating would heat up stage one and it would potentially break it apart. So we got to slow it down. From there, stage one is going to coast its way back down using those grid fins to help steer it. And then it'll execute the landing burn. That's going to happen at T plus 9 minutes and 24 seconds. That's where we're going to reignite that center E9 engine. to hopefully bring stage one down to a beautiful stop right on the drone ship.
That's right. And while all that's happening, the second stage, which you can see glowing bright here, continuing to power Dragon, it's going to continue burning until just about 9 minutes after launch. So at 8 minutes and 59 seconds is where it's targeted to cut off. Down to a single engine, but that one providing a little over 200,000 pounds of thrust to carry Dragon through the upper parts of Earth's atmosphere. Not as much resistance to fight against once you're up this high. And it's going to get Dragon into that initial orbit, and it's still going to be a couple hundred kilometers beneath the station, and then it'll be turned over to thrusters on Dragon once it separates from that second stage to then begin the chase down of the orbiting laboratory. But 5 minutes, 11 seconds, and counting past launch. All the calls so far indicating nominal performance. So we're continuing to see great stuff so far from both both stages of Falcon 9.
Okay, we're hearing that MVAC is performing nominally. It's looking good on power. Temperatures are good. And stage one continues to come back nominally. And look over there on the left on your screen. You see that picture of Ripley in that zero-G indicator.
That's right. Keep an eye out as long as we have the view. As soon as Dragon's separated and it's essentially then in its free flight mode, you're going to see that little planet Earth start to float up. So keep an eye out once we separate Dragon in just a couple of minutes from now. 6 minutes past launch.
Trajectory continues to be nominal on stage two. About 2.5 more minutes left of this burn, at which point MVAC will shut down. We're just under a minute away from that entry burn on stage one that I mentioned before. Stage burn continues to burn nominally.
Sorry, we're over 7 minutes since that liftoff. Feels like it was 30 seconds ago. Continuing to carry Dragon up. It's going to make it to that initial orbit after it separates. The separation coming about a minute after that second stage cutoff.
Stage two, propellant tank pressures are looking good. The burn continues to be healthy. Now coming up in about 10 seconds, that entry burn is going to start. Hopefully we'll have onboard video and you'll be able to watch. Let's listen in on the call outs.
Stage one, FTS is safe.
Stage one, entry burn has started.
Look at that plane. So three M1D engines reigniting. Burn is going to continue on for about another 18 or so seconds.
Yeah, so a little back-to-back action now as we see stage one coming back down towards Earth. Stage two still making its way up into outer space. The Dragon still nestled on top, getting ready.
Stage one entry burn and shutdown.
And there's the end of that stage one
stage
shutdown.
Okay, so stage one is going to continue to coast its way down using those grid fins for attitude control and steering.
Next
and in just under a
minute.
Yeah, that's right. It's coming up in about 10 seconds. MVAC throttling now for SECO.
Stage one is transponic.
And we have had a successful shutdown. MVAC. All right. Stage one landing burn is supposed to start. At the start of that burn, stage one would be traveling at 275 meters per second. That single engine burn is going to bring that from 275 to zero.
We did just hear that stage one landing burn has started.
All right, let's see if we get it. Away from where it launched from. The vehicle will now undergo its safing procedures, and the recovery team will make sure it's strapped down and it'll make its way back to Earth. Or, sorry, back to Cape Canaveral. It's already on. So there's still a lot more to go here. We have Dragon separation coming up. Let's go back to Tom Perderio to cover that next big milestone.
Wow, what a landing. Coming up very shortly, in just about 20 seconds here, the Dragon spacecraft is going to be separating from the top of the Falcon 9 rocket. Separation should be occurring around 11 minutes and 5 seconds, just about now. Let's wait for confirmation.
Dragon, separation confirmed.
And there it is. You're looking at a view from the top of the second stage of the Falcon 9 rocket. And hard to make out in the shadow of the Earth, but that is the Dragon 2 spacecraft flying in space for the first time after a successful separation.